What I see is the need to respond to the dignity and of the people that we see coming to our border and that need our help. I visited the detention facility when back in 2014 when the children were detained, and when I walked in there, they were all crying, asking me to please help them, to get them out of there. Get me out of here. I can't breathe. I want my mother. It is truly not at all political. It is who we are as human beings.
Hola, chiquita.
When somebody is totally against the idea of helping someone, like in this case, immigrants or the refugees, all they have to do is come and see. And I've had that happen to me before, where a lady comes over and says, "Sister, I'm 100% against what you're doing." And I said, "Let me show you what I do and why." And I have her walk with me through the area and show her the people and see the faces and the families and the children. And then she turns around and tells me, "I'm 100% in favor of what you're doing."
Missionary of Jesus, Sister Norma Pimentel, works to meet the basic humanitarian needs of the large number of migrants who enter the U.S. legally at the border crossing in McAllen, Texas. The people and families that arrive here have been processed at the border and granted temporary legal status. They stay at the Respite Center for an average of 24 hours before moving on to their intended destinations in the U.S. Cardinal Supich and a delegation from Catholic Extension met with migrants who had just arrived.
I went and talked to each of them about where they came from, who was with them, where they were going, to let them know that the church welcomed them and would be ready to assist them in their own journey. That very human experience stays with me probably the most.
The people that we are actually helping do have temporary legal status. People that are coming to our country are actually turning themselves into the Border Patrol. They are asking for help. They're saying, "Help me, I need protection. My life is not safe in my country." They're from Salvador, Guatemala, and Honduras. Those are the three main countries. Of course, we've seen from almost 30, 40 different countries that have come through our center since we've opened, people from China, from Japan, from Africa, from everywhere have come through our doors. I think that we never should feel that we've done enough, because there's always more to do.
I, Cardinal Blaise Supich of Chicago, humbly present this plaque commemorating a $100,000 gift for the construction of this humanitarian respite center.
I think of my grandparents, who were also immigrants. They were helped by a lot of people to, when they landed in New York, to come across the United States, settling in Omaha, Nebraska. It took a lot of people who volunteered, individuals who made a difference in allowing that to happen. So this is, in a way, payback.
The reality is that we live on the Rio Grande River in the Diocese of Brownsville are realities that are of families that in many instances have been there for generations, influenced by the culture of Mexico for historical reasons. And yet, currently, we're seeing right now, of course, the phenomenon of immigration. We hear a lot of the negative stuff that happens in some of our poor communities, especially with the issue of immigration. There's a lot of rhetoric that goes, that kind of misses the point that we're talking about people, and that people need to help people and help take care of people. When people have a chance to get together and encounter each other, as the Holy Father says, then the work of grace can bear great fruit.
In the past 5 years alone, Catholic Extension has provided more than $12 million to help build up and strengthen the Catholic community in the U.S.-Mexico border region. Since its founding, donors to Catholic Extension have given $120 million to the dioceses along the border, a place that is home today to more than 4 million Catholics from very diverse backgrounds. Catholic Extension is there to serve them all.
The work of Catholic Extension in helping those dioceses, those local churches, those bishops who live day to day with the experience of immigrants coming into their own diocese and their local church, is an opportunity for us to link people throughout this country who don't have that experience. What Catholic Extension is doing is stretching the imagination and the understanding of Catholics who are donating to it to help its wonderful work beyond maybe their own way of thinking. It's an opportunity that we offer to people for conversion of heart, to grow in their faith.
We're living up to the best tradition of what Catholicism has been in the United States, which has been a Catholicism that has been open to the immigrant from wherever they might be coming, whether it's Europe or Asia or the Philippines or Africa. This is really sort of the dynamism of our time, and we have to, as a church, be a people who put always the human face of Christ in front of us first.
The U.S. Catholic Church has a long and proud tradition of being an immigrant church, extending mercy and welcoming the stranger. Support of these ministries is central to the historic role of Catholic Extension in building up the Catholic Church across the United States.